హాయ్, వెల్కమ్ టు బార్నీటెక్ ఛానల్. దిస్ సెక్షన్ వి ఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు సీ అబౌట్ స్పామ్ 150C రిలే ఫుల్ డీటెయిల్ అబౌట్ హార్డ్వేర్ కనెక్షన్ అండ్ సెట్టింగ్స్ ఫర్ ద రిలే. ఫస్ట్ వి సీ ది హార్డ్వేర్ కనెక్షన్ ఫర్ దిస్ రిలే. దిస్ రిలే హ్యాస్ అ 3 హార్డ్వేర్ కనెక్షన్ స్లాట్ అండ్ 1 కమ్యూనికేషన్ పోర్ట్ అవైలబుల్ అట్ ద బ్యాక్ సైడ్ ఆఫ్ ద రిలే. వి సీ 1 by 1. The first slot 61, 62, 63, this 3 point is for power supply for the relay. In 61 we have to connect phase or positive supply. In 62 is for neutral or negative. In 63 is for grounding. That means we can give power supply for this relay either AC or DC. And for this type of relay we have 2 different power supply value. One is 220 volt AC or DC, another one is 80 volt DC or AC power supply. If we give wrong power supply, then the power cord will get damaged. So before giving the power supply, we need to ensure the relay power cord first. If we need to check easily, the voltage will be marked on the front side of the relay. But if you want to see deeply and correctly, then you have to open the front cover of the relay. Inside the cord will have SPTU40 is for 220 volt indication. If you have SPTU48, then it have the indication for 80 volt. So by seeing this, we have to give the power supply for the relay. Next point is 65 and 66, which is used for tripping. This contact is defaultly used without any program. This contact may be normally open or normally closed. This can be also seen in front of this relay. Next point is 74 and 75 is enable for start. This contact is also the defaultly used for close enable for breaker hardware logic. This contact is automatically activated when the relay protection is not having a thermal alarm or any protection activated in the relay. And this contact is used for close enable. Next point is 70, 71 and 72. This contact is also defaultly, it is a watchdog contact for relay internal fault detection. This contact is activated automatically if the relay has any internal problem on binary input cord or binary output cord or any other cord inside the relay. This contact will be activated. This contact is also used for close enable in hardware logic. Next point is 10 and level. Is only one binary input, it is a programmable which can be used for blocking or controlling, which will be seen deeply how to configure on next video. I will show this. Now we go for second card. This card is fully for analog card, only used for sensing current from the CT secondary. The point 1, 2, 3 is the selection for phase CT, and the connection is for 1 and 3 is used for 1 amps for the CT secondary current from S1 and S2. If you want to use for 5 amps, then you need to connect S1 and S2 to 1 and 2 terminal. Similarly, for the terminal 4, 5 and 6 for phase CT and 6, 7, 8 for another phase CT, we can choose any RYB, the 3 phase over here, which is used for motor startup, unbalanced motor protection and current measuring also for this relay. Next point is 25, 26, 27 is similar to current sensing, but this was used for earth fault detection from earth CT. Now we go for next slot, 68, 69. The point is used for programmable output. Next, 77 and 78 is for used for relay pickup or any protection on this relay. If it started, this signal is activated defaultly. Next, 80 and 81 point is used for programmable output. All this programmable has to be configured. If we need to use this output contact, This configuration I will show on next video. Now we will go how to check the relay setting. In front side of the relay, near to display, we can able to see the set or reset button. We have to press this button for 1 second for seeing this relay metering and display. The below shown L1, L2, L3 and I0 are the current metering value or the actual secondary running current. Over here we can able to see I0, TX and P, the value. So we have to press one by one to see for checking the value. This value is used for thermal protection. This I0 indicate the relay settings for full load current. This T6X is used for maximum stall time. The P for weighing factor, which is used for thermal protection. Next, this is also used for thermal protection. Theta A is for thermal alarm value. Theta I for thermal reset. KC for cool time constant. This all used for thermal protection. Next, this is used for motor startup protection. IS is for startup current setting. TS is for startup time setting. Next, this is used for high stage motor protection, the high stage overcurrent current setting, and next is high stage operating time, that is trip time. Next is, this is used for earth fault protection. I0 is for earth fault current setting, and T0 is for earth fault time setting. Next is for unbalanced protection. The delta I is for unbalanced current setting, and T delta is for operating time for this unbalance. Next is for undercurrent protection. This is for undercurrent set current setting value. This T is for operating time. Next is for motor supervision. The summation of TSI is time based start inhibit count. The delta TS bar delta T is countdown rate of the start time counter. Next, for SGP, SGR and SGF, this all three we will see on next video deeply. If you press the reset button continuously, then all this value will show very fast. If you push the button below 1 second, then the cursor will move towards the backside of the settings. Now we will see how to change the relay settings. Press reset button to locate where you need to change the settings. Once you located the settings where you need to change, then press the programmable button for 5 seconds. After 5 seconds, the setting will start to blink. And again, you have to press this programmable button slightly, then the individual value will start to blink, and in which place you have to change the value, you have to select the point by pressing this programmable button. Once you located the value, then you can increment or decrement the value by pressing this press and reset button. This value can be raised from 9 to 0. If you want to decrement the value, then you can choose from 0 to 9 according to your value, or if you can also do increment. Once you change the value, then if you want to save this value, you have to go to program and you have to press the button one by one until this whole value will start to blink. Once it start to blink, then you need to press both reset button and programmable button at a time. When you press both at a time, then your value is going to save, and you have to ensure once again the value is changed or not. I hope this section may be useful for you all. On next section, we will see deeply how to do settings value and do configuration for this relay. We came to the end of this section. See you on next video. If you like this section, then please share to your friends and colleagues. Take care and bye from Barney Tech channel. Thank you for watching this video.